I was training for almost 6 months before we started shooting. And so I was training a bunch of different kind of martial arts, training jiu-jitsu, Brazilian jiu-jitsu, and taekwondo, and kickboxing, and Filipino kali fighting, like knife fighting, and then also more traditional stunt work.
What was the toughest one? Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
Toughest one, I don't like what Brazilian jiu-jitsu got me really obsessed. So that's what kind of stuck. I'm training it like 3-4 times a week.
I've heard that from people who start doing jiu-jitsu that
it's
very addictive. What's so addicting about it?
It's you're in a situation where you're 100% competing, and but you don't like lose brain cells. It's like if you're sparring and boxing, it's like you can't really go full speed. You get knocked out or knock somebody out. It's not good. But in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, you can really compete, and it is very effective self-defense. If it's one of the first times I was training Jiu-Jitsu, I'm like 195, 200 pounds and pretty athletic. And I was sparring against this girl who's about 115, 120 pounds. And I was like, okay, I guess we can play around a little bit. And she just tied me up in a knot and choked me out. And had I not given up, I would have gone unconscious. And so it's like, it's very effective in that way. And then it becomes like human chess. So I love to play chess. And it's... it's the only sport I've come where you sort of employ the same part of your brain.
Sort of the thinking two or three steps ahead.
Two or three steps ahead, and when you're when you start to understand what's happening, and you can tell like, okay, he's moving that there, he's threatening to do that. Oh, he's actually probably setting a trap by doing that. So what he actually wants to do is like, oh shit, he's got his hand on my left ankle. That's what he really wanted to do. And then you address that instead of the problem. Yeah,
the slight move.
Yeah, and the thing is that if you don't address it, then you go unconscious.